COMELEC plans to continue its preparations despite President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s signing of the law postponing the Barangay and Sanggunian Kabataan elections, originally scheduled for December 2022. Joining us live is John Eric Mendoza. Eric?
Yes, Neil. The COMELEC is set to resume the voter registration in November this year. COMELEC Chairman George Erwin Garcia told reporters Thursday that the poll registration for the upcoming Barangay and Sanggunian Kabataan elections will last for 6 months, beginning in the last week of November until the last week of May 2023. This comes after President Bongbong Marcos signed into law the bill suspending the village and youth election originally scheduled for December 2022. Garcia said it is looking into reactivating 5 million more regular and youth voters by the end of the registration program. The 2022 elections will be delayed for almost another year, as the next village and youth council election would be held on the last Monday of October 2023 and be held every 3 years after. Despite this, Garcia said that the poll body would still continue its preparation for the elections in case the Supreme Court grants a temporary restraining order against the postponement. Neil?
Eric, so the preparation will still continue despite the new law, but I'm just curious, what is the stand of the COMELEC on the postponement of the Barangay and SK elections?
Yes, Neil. Actually, the COMELEC has made clear its stand on this. Garcia said it would be better if the elections will push through in December, and the whole body actually continued this preparation even if they are already built, seeking a suspension filed before the Congress. In fact, Election Watchdog's Legal Network for Truthful Election, or LENTE, NAMFREL, and the PPCRB also opposed the delay in election. Neil?
Eric, has the COMELEC raised any issues possibly arising from this postponement?
Yes, Neil, definitely. The COMELEC said that the government has to shell out another 10 billion pesos for the conduct of the Barangay and SK elections on October next year. That is due to the additional cost of election paraphernalia, cost for the printing of more ballot boxes, and the honoraria for the members of the electoral board. But Neil, you know, as expected, Garcia said that he trusts the wisdom of the president and the lawmakers who pushed for his suspension. Neil?
Okay. That's John Eric Mendoza reporting live.